As we come to this space, I just invite us to pause, check your phones, ideally maybe even turn them off. The invitation has been given to let the photographer do the work today, and to, rather than using your own phones or other devices to take photos, just put them aside and enjoy the moment live rather than through the viewfinder. My name is Rev Tony Franklin-Ross. It's my privilege to welcome you here to this space as we come on this most special of days to celebrate this marriage. Welcome. At the end of the service, we are trusting the weather, and we will be invited to follow the grooms out into the forecourt to hear the bells ringing out for their celebration. And while you're doing that out in the forecourt, there'll be the opportunity for the afternoon tea to be reset and made available, and then you're invited back in. Should, by some chance, the weather have turned just at that point, we'll have to improvise and maybe just gather at the peace chapel over to the side here if it's not too good to be outside. But we'll trust the weather will hold. So let us center ourselves in this place with one another and with God.
There has been a separate journey which has brought us
this point. In particular, a welcome to the mothers that are here, Aaron and Margaret, a very warm welcome as you share and celebrate this next part of their journey. And greetings also to those who are watching from afar via live stream. Scott and Bernie, you have chosen to continue your journey together, and you have invited us as your family, friends, and fellow travellers to witness to your commitment together. We give you this, our time for your time, our attentiveness, and our love as you make your promises to one another. As we do so, invite us to pray. Et iatra, God of love, creator of the world, we offer to you our lives, our words and deeds, our hopes and fears, and our love for each other. Accept us as we are, make us what we shall be, and by the power of your Spirit, enable us to be a sign of your presence in the world. Especially today, we ask your blessing on Scott and Bernie, who come here in this moment of their lives. Help them as they make their promises to each other, that they shall pledge their vows of sincerity. Grant to us all a heightened sense of joy in life, because we share this moment with them. Amen. We are invited to join together in singing a hymn, as printed in the Orders of Service. All things bright and beautiful. the colours of lavender and green for this day and for this week. But these are colours rich with meaning for rainbow communities. Violet was the colour of the 7th century Lesbian Rusakov, and it captured the imaginations of writers and poets through to the 19th century. Many queer men of the time, such as writer Oscar Wilde, wore a green carnation as their flower of choice and referred to the night spent with other men as their purple nights. The American poet Walt Whitman used the green colour for similar purposes. And in the 20th century, particularly through the influence of lesbian playwrights in the 1920s, lavender and lilac replaced mauve and violet, and lavender became a slang term for a gay man. Colours have and continue to be a source of inspiration and energy for the rainbow communities, whose history is one of oppression, fear and hatred, but also one of hope, love, and community. We're here today as the latter to share hope for future, of our love and the love of Bernie and Scott, and for the community that we form together here. Lesbian theologian Carter Hayward captures much of the celebration of same-sex love with a series of words which I'll invite Charles Brinton to share with us.
To say I love you is to say that you are not mine, but rather your own. To love you is to advocate your rights, your space, yourself, and to struggle with you, rather than against you, in our learning to claim our power in this world. To love you is to make love to you and with you, whether in an exchange of glances heavy with existence, in the passing of a piece we mean, in common work or play, in our struggle for social justice, or in the ecstasy and tenderness of intimate embrace that we believe is just and right for us and for others in the world. To love you is to be pushed by a power, God, both terrifying and comforting. To touch and be touched by you. To love you is to sing with you, cry with you, pray with you, and act with you to recreate the world. To say, I love you, means let the revolution begin.
And so today we are celebrating a new creation. We are celebrating the touching and flowing together of two life streams, the joining together of two strands in the web of the universe. The public affirming of this relationship is to provide the context for loving relationship to develop and to grow. It calls for capacity to both give and take, to forgive and be forgiven. It provides the opportunity for mutual support and sharing, the encouragement to take risk and the chance to gain. In choosing to weave their lives together in the relationship of marriage, Scott and Bernie are making the most important and sacred commitment that two people can make to each other. And so I invite you to respond to some questions and vows. Scott and Bernie, have you come here today freely and without reservation to give yourselves to each other in marriage? Will you, Scott and Bernie, take each other to be your lifelong companion, lover and friend? Will you spend your lives together, seeking to fulfill each other's needs, growing together so that you may share your strengths and bear each other's weaknesses? Will you share each other's freedom to grow as individuals and allow each other time and space to do so? Will you love, honor, and cherish each other, dwell together in harmony and love, that your relationship may bear fruit in the way it touches your family, friends, and those around you? And now your direct vows. Time to the handkerchief. in the turning of the earth and the cycle of the seasons, in the dance of sun, moon and stars and all of the cosmos on the great journey of life. The circle of love encompasses all, promises all, and gives birth to all and protects all. And so these rings are a sign that you have chosen each other to share life's journey. Eternal God, bless these rings, that they may be symbols of the love and trust between Bernie and Scott. Amen. In the presence of us all, Scott and Bernie have made their solemn vows. They have confirmed their marriage by the joining of hands and the giving and receiving of rings. By the powers vested to me as a minister and as a marriage servant, I am now honoured to pronounce you married.
Oh.
And we will be doing a group photo, which will be taken from the balcony, which is why I was doing this about not going up there, but going anyway. That way we get this a great way, especially the church like here, to have the balcony photo to be able to catch everyone who was here in this place to share that moment. But before we do so, Scott and Bernie, you have committed yourselves to one another in love, joy, and tenderness. You stand on the threshold of an experience or relationship which can touch the richest meanings and deepest mysteries of human life. We have shared this moment with you and pray you will continue to grow in hope and love. Go in peace and celebrate your lives together, knowing that God is with you both. In the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, may God bless you and your mutual love, now and always. Amen. And so we do that prayer right now, and all smile together in sharing.
Just these guys, if you can align, maybe take the row. Oh, so we see the ladies, so maybe you can go in that row there. Yeah, thank you. I can fit you in now. Okay, wonderful. Okay, 1, 2, 3. One more. Thank you.
So to all of us who have gathered here today and have been watching online, may God's love refresh the lives of all of us. May the vows made by Scott and Bernie remind us of our love for others and God's desire for a world of love and justice. And so go in peace, and it's no secret bar that's just spoken that all these guys are dashing across. They've got their own bar upstairs, aren't they? It's the Bellringers heading to ring out Peel, my main name on full Peel. And as we process that, we'll be able to hear those bells rung out in celebration as one of the many ways that this service is personalised through interest, through colour, through music, through song, and through each other. Let us all go in peace.